There always seems to be one rookie that everyone's talking about when the show begins. Johnny Curtis appears to be that guy.
First, I'd like to make a shout out to the WWE Universe. Vote for Curtis. A vote for me is a vote for freedom.
I am Derek Bateman.
Derek Bateman loves creative writing, rocking out, and wacky outfits.
The superstar who is fantastic, just the way you like it.
It's Byron Saxton.
You're going to be money.
Bam! Together, you and I will become WWE's next breakout star!
WWE Universe, recognize Brodus Clay.
You got all the tools. If you just listen to me, this competition is yours.
And if you're not cool with that, there's two things you can do about it. Nothing and like it. And you do know that.
Dayton, Ohio. Hey. You know, my whole life I've been made fun of for the simple fact that I look like a rat. Rats lurk in the shadows waiting to strike on the opportune moment. That takes the cheese. See?
I like that game, Monopoly, because you got to own your competition.
Welcome to your first rookie challenge. Capture the flag.
Jacob trying to break the time to beat.
Jacob Novak, the winner in the first rookie challenge.
On season 4 of NXT, I'm going to own the entire board.
A brand new crop of young, talented men, all with the desire to become the next breakout star.
Well, don't go anywhere, because two superstars who know each other better than anyone, I'm talking former best friends, former roommates, clash in a bitter battle. That's next on WWE Superstars.
Preparation for the Slammies, our friends at WWE.com are now featuring the most memorable video clips of 2010. Give us your picks for Superstar, Diva, Tag Team, and Match of the Year at Facebook.com/WWE. A young man who, if he could, would give himself the Slammy for Superstar of the Year. Arrogant, cocky, but certainly capable, Curt Hawkins.
No shortage of confidence for Hawkins. Matt, Hawkins and Beretta were once best friends. They trained together. They shared the same dream. What happened?
Well, they say familiarity breeds contempt. Maybe Curt Hawkins was jealous, or perhaps Trent Beretta just really claims the spotlight.
They were once like brothers, now they want to rip each other apart. Two of the bright young superstars here in the WWE set to be battled.
And again, anyone watching at home, and if you're young or old, I'm sure you have a best friend in your life or a coworker, someone that you see every day, someone that you know so well, someone who perhaps was a big part of your life, and now you've had a falling out. Think of what you want to do to them.
I'm tired of doing this every week. I gotta beat you up. Every week this happens, huh? What are you gonna get to do? Hey, you're not at my level. You got that? You're not at my level. You're not.
Oh, bam, there you go. I mean, come on, any guy watching, if you've ever been mushed in the face, that's what you got to do. Trent Beretta, you're not on Curt Hawkins' level. We're about to find out.
Clearly, Beretta has had enough as he goes immediately to work on Hawkins. You know, last week, oh, wait, here we go, early cover. Hawkins kicks out. Hawkins was out here on commentary last week, said some very derogatory things about Trent Beretta, said if this was the Attitude Era, Hawkins is The Rock, and Beretta is Headbanger Mosh.
Well, of course, Hawkins referring to Headbanger Mosh, who, you know, wasn't that great. Hang on a second.
Here we go.
wasn't a household name. But take nothing away from the superstars of today. Let's not look at yesterday. Let's look at Trent Barretta with maneuvers such as that. Look at Curt Hawkins as well. I think Hawkins only served to light a fire under Barretta with that early diatribe.
We've learned here in recent weeks that Barretta is not afraid to take a risk. Last week, did a moonsault on the arena floor. He said he will let it all hang out, anything he has to do to score a victory over his former best friend.
I like what Barretta's doing here. He's slowing the pace down. This serves to frustrate Curt Hawkins.
Beautiful side headlock here, wearing Hawkins down. How does that just suck the air right out of you?
Well, your opponent's laying on top. He makes it hard to breathe. Hawkins realizes that, trying to get back to a vertical base.
Back up to their feet now. In the ropes. Oh, big collision. Barretta getting the best of that one. Frankensteiner by Barretta.
I like that you called it a Frankensteiner, not a Hunan Kanrana. Cover here. They're two entirely different moves. It shows that you do your homework there, Jackie boy.
Thank you, Matt. From you, that means a lot.
And again, right back to the side headlock takeover.
Well, typically Barretta is carefree, out for a good time, but you can see tonight it is all business. Of course, the master of the gobstopper knee.
What is the gobstopper? That's the knee to the mouth, right?
He said it causes everlasting pain.
Okay. Did he say it just like you just said it?
Everlasting pain.
It's like Luther Vandross. Well, this is where, if Curt Hawkins gets an opening, you're going to see Hawkins' frustration come out.
Are we watching the future of the WWE right here? Possibilities endless for these two young superstars. Oh, Hawkins. Oh, my God.
Oh, the kid just hit his head on the steel steps. Can Trent Barretta find a way back? Or has Curt Hawkins turned this match around? We'll find out when Superstars continues.
Welcome back to WWE Superstars, everybody. Matt Stryker and Jack Capello with you. We are watching an incredibly physical and competitive matchup between former best friends Hawkins and Barretta.
And before we went away to the commercial break, watch Trent Barretta, the guy in the long tights, watch his head, bam, bounces right off the steel steps. And since then, Curt Hawkins has been punishing his former best friend.
Matt, is there any way Barretta can get back into this matchup after something like that?
Oh, sure. Don't never count out any superstar in the WWE. It only takes 3 seconds for victory and 1 second for the momentum to change.
There you go. This could be the break that Barretta was waiting for. With authority, does he have the wherewithal to make the cover? As you can see, Barretta still licking his wounds here. This match taking a tremendous toll on both superstars. Who will gain the upper hand? Now hammering away on Hawkins, trying to make Hawkins pay for all of those derogatory comments.